What's that?
No, this is full speed. It's about 3 minutes to go to the bow.
It's like your base elevator, right?
It is, yeah.
No cables.
Correct, yep. No cables, no hydraulics. This has four motors with gearboxes. They call this like a cog drive, so it's got the pinion gears and they, they intertwine, with the rails and whatnot. But actually, this whole elevator, when it takes off, goes straight, kind of goes in, but it actually follows a whole structure. Unlike they have things more like funicular, where it travels up on one angle like this, but this is very unique. They have this.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
I noticed there was a hydraulic press under the bridge in certain floors.
Well, the hydraulic press also, like right now, as we're going on this angle, that hydraulic press actually is constantly articulating to keep the cab portion perfectly vertical.
Gotcha.
If not, as we were going on this angle, we'd all be on top of each other back and forth.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's really neat. It doesn't have traveling cables. It gets its power similar to like the subway. You'll see once we start moving over this way again, just like the railroad and the subway with the bus bars, because this does have the traveling cables because of the angles it travels on. It's actually Wi-Fi controlled. There's a ton of technology and engineering, imagine.
But
so that's where it gets the high voltage power for the motors, and then on that side the low voltage for all your switches and lights and fans and stuff. So a ton of engineering. It's all around the world like it.
So it's like completely detached from the system, almost like a train where you have a rail.
Exactly. And then under where we're standing, there's a computer that's like a Wi-Fi router, and that sends a signal to our controller, which is located underneath this entire project. But yeah, it really is. I've been installing elevators 17 years and never anything like this. A really neat project.
You have to wait. If you guys aren't next to it, okay?